if we incorporate muscles in the whole body, use the power from my whole body. The short distance punch doesn't come in from swinging our punch here. You okay here? No problem. It comes from a coil, look, where I have an effect. I can transfer, kind of create a coiling force from an angle.
This video describes the internal martial art principle of fa jin, what it means to me and how I practice it. Technically, fa jin means to release or discharge power, but there are many different interpretations of what exactly that means. The kind of fa jin discussed here will not be that requires the opponent to push you while you're in a stable, solid stance, creating kind of a bounce back effect. Even if that kind of fa jin could work, it isn't something that could be applied in real combat, since in the chaos of real fight, it is near impossible for a person to solidly plant both feet on the ground when someone is trying to push them or hurt them. Another kind of fa jin that involves a snapping of fists, elbows, etc. during solo practice. I have more than 50 years of training in the martial arts, and I've seen a lot, and sorry, I never got this. I don't understand it and what exactly the purpose is. For me, a real fa jin, real internal power, is something that should be street tested and trained with opponents so the students can see if their material is really working under the stress of combat. And students should never be expected to just believe in the power abilities of a master or a particular technique without personal experience. This is also not the kind of fa jin, the kind that my Bagua cousins in Beijing tried to get me to do when I was there, where you kind of pop or learn to jump back and you feel what force is issued against you. Type of fa jin internal power expression I specialize in looks soft and releases power into the opponent. The softness of the practice is the same way it looks in the real fight. That is fa jin to me. I feel this is the real goal of internal martial art teaching. Practice should look light, but at the same time, be incredibly effective. There are two parts to this kind of training. One part is biomechanical, and the other part is mental, energetic, and emotional. Bruce Lee was a master of the biomechanical. His famous one-inch punch is the epitome of felt force, counterforce, essentials of the internal martial art. That kind of force is produced by connecting the front leg on the power to the technique as the weight shifts forward and the body moves in a vertical way. It is essentially the best example of force and counterforce training. That's why I stressed in many of my other videos about the importance of the knee going backwards and not being pointy. You need that kind of pull up through the body to present that counterforce. Notice how Bruce Lee's knee goes backwards as he's delivering the punch forward. In this kind of training, the forces and counterforces are brought and cooperated with in a reaction way through the whole body to present that type of short power. There's another aspect of the biomechanics of internal martial arts that involves spiral principles of the body, where spiral techniques are drawn and applied through the whole system.
It's brought into the opponent this way and transfers through his body. So instead of hitting in a what we might call a horizontal mode, I call this a vertical mode, because it's brought from the ground in a coiling spring-like motion and transfers into the body.
part two is mental and energetic. Adapted for application to the internal martial arts, the Taoist way of describing this aspect of internal energy training has to do with developments from Taoist yoga, where energy centers of the middle and lower dantian are focused on and activated to present energy influences to the opponent. Here, the force-counterforce aspects discussed earlier are concentrated into the body, where energetic forces are pressures into the bones, and from the dantian, the electrical currents are triggered that can influence the opponent. The result in this kind of fajing practice is that it produces a weakening effect against the opponent. In practical terms, what this means is that your opponent is less able to resist your technique. So now we have two factors working. You have the energetic component along with the physical component that interacts and affects the opponent.
From the lightest touch.
Both coming together represents the ideal in internal martial art training.
From a short distance by using the coiling system of the
That's why it's very important for all internal martial artists seeking to understand what their masters really knew.
And I'm not taking attention to my body.
Work toward perceiving and attaining this electromagnetic field in your body, which has an influence against the opponent. And this demonstration is not so much that I'm super power resisting the opponent, but instead I am able to influence his ability to push on me because of the field. So two things combined together, good technique and understanding, and working with the electrical field of your body to produce an influence. I'll write extensively on this and put it in the our web pages.
So maybe if two of them, like, Dermot, come here, help me against this. Looking like a rugby player that attacks the one, huh? For sure. So here, at that moment where we are, I'm in confrontation, I don't have to stiffen up where I'm restricted, see? For Tai Chi or Xing or Bagua, we can. Pushing, I can move pretty easily around them and move instantly because I'm not tense. As he pushes and locks, I can move it this way, push hard. I can maintain contact, I can move around fairly easy. And my power then, push hard as you can, is pretty minimally controlled. So I can lock here, and maybe I can lock and apply force. Point now. Yeah, I'm not tensed. So you can lift and grab me here, push me here. I can be here, or I can be there. I can be there. I can have power there. I can have power there. I can have power there. He pushes at me again. I'm here. Now pushing here. It gives me freedom of looseness. So instead of being restricted, here, he just grabs me, pushing. If I tensed up, I can't move. I'm so relieved that he's pushing me. He doesn't feel anything here. I can lock my opponent, see? Because it is freedom. And that's flowing down tien then. Gives me the maximum freedom. Grab me, push me hard. It gives me maximum freedom to move, coil, twist. Sort of like a serpent moving, coiling, twisting. And this is my understanding then of it. This should be the way we develop the push hands, by floating, coiling, carrying the power from the feet, and connecting. It looks like this. The push hands, it looks like this. Push in. Good. Stay here. Feel it?
Yeah.
In Bagua, it looks like this. We call it single change. Jim, grab. So here, grab again. So second attack, moving here. In hsing-i, grab right, left hand grab. Here, looks like this. Or right hand grab here. Here, same move. In the Tai Chi standard form, it's this move. Here, so if you push this from here, two-hand grab. Tai Chi standard form here. If I'm just walking around the room, minding my own business, a mean person over here, taxi, I can use it in combat. You know, floated, not tensing up. And critical in the development of this concept is that we do not lock down our body. We feel like this is floating, and we feel like a looseness to it, and staying calm under any kind of combat, which allows us for our power to be expressed through the coil and through the movement.
Yep.
Here. So a couple of these is effective. And then I could use that force and that body, that connection, through my whole body. So if you pushed in, pushing it come inside or inside or back. And in general, you don't want to do this. You don't want to have this wobble effect. You want to have a straighter grab here. You know, kind of a straighter move. And then from here, and then the return push in. The bagua, using a coin, transferring the palm for close range attack defense. It might look like this. So here, and grab here. Okay, this is a wrist and toe shot. See you now.
Could be used for bagua. It could be a Tai Chi move, push your hand, or the back just carries the force, or it could be thought of as a combat movement, or either way. So here, you're pushing hands, you're coiling to your body, your body's ready to coil and respond. This here translates as loss of effectiveness. You should try to avoid that habit. You try to grab hard. As much as possible, keep the coil inside and release the coil from inside. All those ideas is that we don't want to use our shoulders here. We want to use a coiling effectiveness from our whole body. Pushing here. I'm not going to attack with a one hit here, but a hit where I can bring the body into this area. We put on a special effect again, visually, to see what we're doing. It doesn't want to look like a swing. This doesn't look so much like a swing. Instead, it would look like a coiling.
The difference?
Yes.
The same thing.